When it comes to fitness, we're taught to chase strength. Train harder, run faster, lift heavier. What if the secret to real performance, the kind that lasts decades, isn't just in what we do, but how we recover? I'm Nick Hall, Editor-in-Chief of Man of Many, and today I'm on a mission to unpack what true health really means. We've teamed up with the experts from Melrose Health Future Labs to explore three key concepts of health: longevity, recovery, and mental strength. This isn't just about the workout, it's about what happens after, and the science of staying sharp, both inside and out. To live longer is one thing, but to live better is an entirely different pursuit. And no one understands this better than Neal Mercado. With over 25 years experience in the wellness space, he's an expert at translating complex biochemistry into easy, actionable health advice. What he's found in his research is that longevity doesn't always happen in the gym, but in how you prioritize performance. Neal, when we talk about longevity, what are we actually referring to?
Firstly, there's the concept of how long you live, or your lifespan, how many years you live on this earth. But when we're talking about longevity, we talk more in the quality of your life, or the health span, how many years you live without chronic disease, being able to live a happy and full life.
Unpack the pillars of longevity for me.
I would put them as cellular health, how your body maintains its health of mitochondria and different genes. Also look at metabolic health, how well you're able to metabolize sugars, carbohydrates. I would also look at muscular health and bone health. As you age, that's critically important. Cardiovascular health is really critical as well. I'd also look at then kind of the neural side, so cognition, stress, and sleep. And probably lastly would be hormonal health.
Now, I think a lot of people are, as they get older, chasing energy and focus. Can you give me a bit of an example or an understanding about what happens in your body as you get older in those two frameworks?
So when we age, our cells become older. Our cells become less active and more complacent. Kind of this concept of cellular senescence, which is, I don't know if you've ever heard of the concept of zombie cells, or the concept that every 7 years our body renews itself.
Exactly, yeah.
That's exactly what this concept is.
And how can we address those things naturally?
Firstly, your diet, making sure that you have a really nutrient-dense diet, staying away from processed foods, making sure that you're staying active, you're getting your heart rate up, you're doing some level of weight-bearing exercise to keep your muscles going, and then probably evidence-based supplements as well.
So tell me a bit about Time Capsule. What gaps in people's health does this product aim to support?
With Time Capsule, we really strove to hit all of the key pillars of aging. So cellular health from the standpoint of NAD production with precursors in there. Metabolic health from a glucose metabolism perspective. We've got some resveratrol in there for sirtuin AMPK activation. We have also magnesium in there at an important level, L-theanine for stress. We have a number of activated B vitamins for healthy methylation. And then D3 and K2 for both bone and cardiovascular health.
Now, if everyone watching could walk away with one lesson learned about health and aging, what would you like that to be?
I would like it to be that health and aging is multifaceted. It's not just one thing. It's not just one supplement. It's not just one thing that you eat or one thing that you do. It's a number of different things, but these things are manageable.
As Neal explains, longevity isn't a silver bullet. It's a discipline, and the real strength starts at the cellular level. Part of that process involves pushing your limits, even in recovery. Sometimes that looks like stillness, other times it can be far less comfortable. One person who knows the benefit of holistic recovery firsthand is Luke Hines, a qualified personal trainer, breathwork coach, and best-selling author. Luke is the kind of person who practices what they preach, namely a philosophy of health honed over years of trial, error, and unapologetic optimism. Luke's seen firsthand how food, movement, and mindset can recalibrate a broken system. And his approach to health is layered. We're talking ice baths, infrared saunas. If anyone's gonna put me through my paces, it's this guy. Luke, what does longevity mean to you beyond just living longer?
So as you do get older, which we all do, how are you getting older? Are you stronger? Are you leaner? Are you fitter? But also, are you clearer? Are you sleeping better? And are you thriving in all elements of your life? That's the biomarker for me, health span over lifespan, so that when I get older, I'm living better rather than just adding candles to the cake.
What are the common misconceptions that you've seen over that period?
In wellness overall, they go, you know what, it's my genetics. I've got terrible genetics. Or, you know, those people around me, it's just luck. And it couldn't be further from the truth. There's a fantastic thing called epigenetics, which is the effect that our lifestyle factors, things like how we move, the food that we eat, the way that we think, the effect that that has on our nervous system. And it's incredibly powerful, but also how our body interprets our DNA. We're not changing our DNA, but we're changing how our body reads our DNA.
So where does food fit into that longevity and sustainability for health?
I think it's got to be two things. Fuel, to energize workouts, to fuel your day, to make sure that your brain is functioning at your job, that you can be a fantastic, supportive person in your family and relationships. But it's also information for your body. Is it going to be pro-inflammatory or is it anti-inflammatory? Is it going to be something that gives your gut a healthy microbiome, supporting that gut-brain access, making sure that you think and feel the best that you possibly can? So yes, feel full, but make it nutrient dense so that you perform well, but also make sure it's telling your body the right things.
We don't really hear that much about recovering well.
Yeah.
So why is that element so important in terms of keeping overall health over a long period?
I think there's two things. Number one, I think for so long we've been taught through media, advertising, socials, diet and exercise. But if you don't focus on that mindset component, not only will the diet and exercise component not actually work in your favor, but you will burn out in all aspects of your life.
So talk to me about breath work. How do you incorporate that into your regime?
Breath work, it's the remote control for your nervous system. You can use it in such an incredibly powerful way. You can use it to upregulate ahead of a performance, ahead of being on camera, ahead of a workout, but you can also use it to downregulate, which is fantastic.
Now I want to talk a bit about infrared saunas as well, because I know you're a big fan of those.
Yes.
What actually happens to your body, and why is that so important when you're doing infrared saunas?
So it increases your heart rate, improves circulation, but it also provides a growth factor to your brain, which is, this is getting kind of on the nerdy side of things, but when you go in a sauna, it promotes a growth factor in your brain that actually supports, repairs, and rebuilds neurons. So a traditional wood sauna with the coals, most of that heat's coming from the outside onto your skin, and that's causing the hot reaction in your body and the sweat. What's unique about the infrared sauna is that the heat is actually milder when you walk in, and it's more of a slower burn. And you're getting a deeper heat reaction. And what that's doing, it's giving us a really, really beautiful cleanse also from the inside out.
I know a lot of people love to do the cold plunge, the spin, they come back in. What's the benefits of kind of immersing your body in those different temperatures back and forth?
Those contrasts are really powerful. Number one, very pro anti-inflammatory activities. When you combine the two, a lot of the science says that it doesn't matter what order you do it in. We're talking great for your immune response. Detoxifying pathways are completely opened up. Fantastic for your brain health, circulatory system. It's a real powerful combo.
Luke, where does Future Labs Total Body Collagen fit into the picture for you?
For me, it's a no-brainer because it's got the four different types of collagen in there. So type one is to support your bones. Type two is for your hair, skin, and nails. Type three is your joints and cartilage. And then type four is your gut lining and your connective tissues. If we're talking about collagen as the scaffolding protein, you want to make sure that you've got all four types in every serve so that you're supporting all the different systems in your body.
If you had one piece of advice that you could give people when it comes to balance, longevity and health, what would that be?
By always coming back to your anchor, and your anchor being your why, you will never be left giving yourself excuses. Why am I doing this right now? And how will I feel in 1 week, 1 month, 1 year, 1 decade if I don't do it? That will make action, and you will make action today.
Love it. Thank you, Luke.
Thank you.
For many of us, the longevity approach to wellness requires a mental reset. The idea that true strength isn't just physical, but in how we show up, focused, clear, and ready, is counterintuitive to what we've been taught. But as Neal explains, positive physical health often starts with mindset. Neal, when we talk about strength, so often we focus on the physical, but how do elements like focus and motivation contribute to your overall health?
The brain consumes 20% of our energy, but only contributes 2% of the weight. So it's a much more overperforming organ. And in this way, really, performance, physical performance really starts in the brain.
So what would you say, in your opinion, are the most overlooked psychological factors when it comes to performance and strength?
So motivation is really key. I would also say just having a restful night's sleep is really important. The ability to recover, the ability to reduce all that inflammation, particularly if you're training a lot. Counter to that, having a session where you are training hard really does help with chronic stress.
How do exercises and workouts like yoga impact your mental clarity?
With yoga, it stimulates a part of the brain, a part of the brain that is responsible for creating alpha waves. And alpha waves give you this sense of calm focus. What's happening, you're calming all of your neurotransmitters, you're increasing these neurotransmitters called GABA, and it results in just alleviating stress and being able to improve, from a cognitive perspective as well, your focus and your energy.
Creatine is something that's always been seen as being helpful for muscle growth. But there's also benefits from a mental clarity perspective, right?
Yeah, you know, creatine has been used for many years in the gym with bodybuilders, and research is starting to demonstrate the importance of creatine for cognitive health, in particular in the elderly as well. How creatine works is our body converts it into phosphocreatine in our cells, and they're found in our muscles, but they're also found in our brain. Creatine is also good because it attracts water to your muscles, so it makes them look fuller and larger, and also more hydrated as well, obviously, as a result of that. But in the brain, this phosphocreatine is readily usable to convert to ATP. And ATP is kind of the energy currency for our cells. So more and more research is finding, in elderly populations specifically as well, the regular use of creatine can really help to improve cognitive function, recall, memory, learning, and maintain a healthy brain.
Tell me a little about testosterone. How does that work? And as we get older, how does that degrade?
Testosterone is one of the most important male hormone. It's responsible for many different functions. Essentially, as we age, once we hit 40, we start to reduce our ability to produce testosterone. And that's on average about 1% per year, but it can vary based on the individual.
So how do these two elements, speaking about testosterone and creatine, work together in the body, particularly for men as they age, and how can you improve that?
Creatine is, it enables your muscles to work harder, helps you with your cognition as well. And healthy testosterone levels help you to utilize that energy to put on more muscle, and also help you maintain a clearer cognition and more energy as well. So it's really harmonious. It's a kind of a virtuous circle, having healthy levels of both of these.
So tell me a little bit about testosterone matrix.
Really dove into the research quite deeply on effective ways to improve and support healthy testosterone levels. And there's an ingredient called testofen, which is an extract of fenugreek. What this has been demonstrated to do, it's been a number of clinical trials on it, but it really helps to maintain healthy testosterone levels. There's a mechanism in our body called aromatase, and aromatase converts testosterone to estradiol. And what we think it does is actually helps to block aromatase, so it maintains your free testosterone levels without converting that.
So Neal, what's the biggest mistake people make when it comes to post-workout recovery?
I'd say the biggest mistake is just a real focus on trying to get as much protein as you can into your body. And that certainly is important, but it's also important not to overlook the other factors. And that's things like getting enough sleep, and making sure that you're giving your body enough time to recover, and reducing that stress. I think if you can do that, it will lead to much better gains in the gym.
Stress less, lift more?
Absolutely.
Love it. Love to hear it. Yeah. Thank you, Neal. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
What I've learned in this process is that health is not a destination. It's not something you arrive at when you hit a goal weight or complete a challenge, but rather an active commitment to the future. As Neal explained, longevity isn't just for biohackers and athletes. It's for anyone who wants to live fully and with intent. The steps don't have to be radical, they just have to be consistent. So maybe it is time that we rethink what true health really is.